Hey guys, since my last begonia video, I've had numerous questions about crucial care tips. My own begonia collection is rapidly growing and mostly sort of consists of some hybrids that I picked up locally. I'm going to be sharing the most important crucial care tips along with my collection and any differences in care these begonias may have. Thanks for checking out this video. I'm Tyler, and if you like what you're seeing or you find this video to be useful, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, or better yet, you can subscribe to my channel. If you don't yet have any begonias of your own, I definitely want to highlight the fact that these are great houseplants because they are so simple to care for. And I'm going to be sharing everything you need to know in this video, so don't sweat it. Begonias grown indoors are quite different than their outdoor cousins. The ones we grow indoors are typically referred to as fibrous begonias, Rex begonias, or rhizomatous begonias. And that sounds way crazier, way more intense than it needs to. I'm going to demystify all of those crazy words and really simplify things for you, so stay tuned. Begonias are known for and cherished for their beautiful foliage. These plants have some of the most dramatic leaves and foliage, and hence why they are growing in popularity. One really simple way to think about the differences, those of the three different types of begonias I was referring to earlier, are their flowers and sort of how the flowers grow and the height and all of that kind of thing is like a really easy way to differentiate between the rhizomatous, fibrous, and Rex. And I'm going to get to all of that shortly. Now, most of the begonias I have here in front of me are actually hybrids, and that means that they've been propagated over time to highlight different aspects of mostly the foliage, but I guess in some cases the flowers too. The basic care tips for these plants are so incredibly simple. Let me break it down for you. They can grow in full to partial sun. I've had great success giving these plants partial sun, and all that means is they get some direct sunlight and some shade. Now for me, what I have done is these plants are kind of like the second row behind a row of plants that are actually on my windowsill. So because they are in that second row, the plants that are in front of them, mostly my hibiscus, creates little pockets of shade, which means that these plants end up getting some direct sun, but also some of that shade as well. When it comes to watering, it's really simple as well. Once the plants start to droop ever so slightly, that is a good signal and sign to me to give them a thorough watering, and let me show you exactly what I mean. This is my Rex begonia, and you can see that it's started to slightly droop, and that's when you are going to want to water it. Now, some have even said that by allowing your begonia to droop ever so slightly like this can actually benefit the plant and benefit their root system by encouraging the roots to strengthen and, you know, become a little bit more robust. So it's totally not a bad thing to let it droop ever so slightly before you give it that thorough watering. During the summer months, you can totally fertilize these guys. I would say probably about twice a month, diluting your fertilizer to about half or quarter strength. And that's basically the long and short of caring for begonias. Let me really quickly take you through the collection of begonias that I have, along with any sort of unique characteristics or any sort of specific care instructions that they may have. Now, this one over here is the YDI cane begonia, and I just love the sort of polka dots on the leaves. It has sort of like a deep ambery red color on the reverse side of the leaves. And one really cool fact about these begonias is because they are cane begonias, they can grow up to 5 feet tall. So this guy is probably, I don't know, I'd say about 1.5 feet right now, and he has quite a ways to go. And if we go to the other side, this one here is the Ring of Fire, and it's named that because of the contrasting deep red burgundy color with that sort of really pale green. And this one, I would love for it to get to the size of my other Rex begonia. Now, this guy here is called the Northern Lights, and I believe this is a hybrid that Logies has created, a nursery close by in Connecticut. And the really great thing about this variety is it has these sort of yellows, greens, lime greens, and even some sort of browns and reds. And depending on how the light's filtering on it, it really does kind of give an effect of the Northern Lights, which is just kind of just jaw-dropping. It looks probably super simple on camera, but don't underestimate this guy. And finally, this is actually a miniature begonia, and this one has little pink flowers. I'll have to get a close-up for you guys, but it's just really cute with the sort of black and red. Totally my jam, and I just love this begonia too. If you're interested in propagating begonias, you'll have to check out my last video. A little update here, I had about 4 leaf cuttings that I had taken from my bigger Rex begonia back here, and 3 didn't make it, but the great news is 1 did, and there's actually a leaf that has started to sprout from this cutting, so it's basically a successful propagation, and I will also try to get some close-ups of this for you guys. I'm not sure how well it will show up on camera, but I'd love to show you. So any tips on propagating, then head to that video and you can see how easily you can propagate your begonias. I guess one final note that I would have in terms of caring for these plants is they do prefer humid conditions, and I think part of the reason I've had such great success with these plants is because they live very close to my humidifier. Please share any questions or comments you may have about your begonias or future potential begonias. Thank you so much for checking out this video. Oh yeah, don't forget to hit the thumbs up button and subscribe to my channel. It would mean so much to me. Thank you again, and miss you guys already. Until the next one.